So what we now do in these types of processes is basically kind of start looking at scales at different octaves. And this was one of the reasons we looked at the whole concept of doing this kind of analysis at different pyramid levels, because each one of them is a different octave. And now we can actually start modeling the signal. And now we can actually start doing all of the processing. And what, of course, comes out is at different scales, we can actually have these Gaussians and stuff like that. And using these Gaussians, we can also start looking at differences of Gaussians. Again, a very similar concept to what we'd done when we did some of the blending using the frequency domain. Basically, look at these types of things. You can see is that we now actually can do the pyramids and start looking at information at different scales. This basically shows us how we can actually do the difference of Gaussians that I was showing you before between different scales. And using that, we can find the extrema points, which are all these examples here. Of course, what we want to do now is find a few specific extrema points. So of course, we would now kind of find all the points that have high contrast, and that starts giving me more features. There's a lot more features here, and of course, now I've started reducing them. And then I get rid of all of the that are not edges, just the corner features, and I get even less number of points. And this starts kind of giving me the features that I want.